is hooked. Oh, oh,
emotions coming from Superlek. Nice
preparing for a Muay Thai match, so yep. He's got to disrupt that natural instinct of catching the leg here in kickboxing.
High kick from Williams.
MAT is a WMC Muay Thai world champion. He's fought primarily in Muay Thai. So this call up to the big league in kickboxing is a gigantic step up. So he's gonna be fighting a lot of his natural tendencies to catch, to elbow. He's gonna have to eliminate two of his favorite weapons and focus on just the six limbs.
Oh, low kick there in the coin from Superlek.
I think one of the problems they're gonna have to solve in Danny Williams' corner when he goes back here, similarly to what we just saw with Rodriguez and Jamie Todd, is that Superlek is the one that's moving forward and going to be seen as the aggressor as this match continues.
Love the leg kicks coming from Superlek early on, because that is going to stop that movement, or at least slow down the movement of Mini T, who's getting on his bicycle and continually moving to that non-dominant side, I'll call it. Can't call anything a Superlek's weak, but he's starting to touch that leg up.
Yeah, you can see the outside of Daniel Williams' left leg there on the thigh. It's starting to look like hamburger already in the first round.
Lance to right does Mini T to close out round one. Styles make fights, and you gotta like the clash of styles between these two in this world title bout.
Take a look at some of the action from that first round. Mini T catches, but then the off balancing of kind of sweeping his leg off to the side and then followed it up with a punch. Let's take a look at a beautiful cross block though from Superlek, right? He catches it off, does knock Superlek off balance, and you can see
that hand tight, understand? Yeah. He's catching with the teeth. Yeah. So counter the teeth, we'll parry the teeth, fire back off straight away. That's it. Focus, Daniel. Walk out there. Show him who's boss. You need to win this next round. Win this next round.
Mini T, born in Thailand, grew up in Australia. Show him who's boss, the message from his corner.
Ready? Two.
The bell in round two. Come right out with a 1-2, Mini T.
In the crowd here, yeah. Showing love to their Australian compatriot. Mini T having a hard time touching the legs of Superlek, and Superlek goes hand hunting, but Mini T showcasing his reflexes, ducking out of the way.
He's been pretty elusive so far, Williams.
The best spot that Superlek's had, the best target has been that leg. You can just see the lead leg of Mini T is not going to be feeling well in that long flight back to Australia tomorrow.
It's not just the leg. Look at the entire left side of the ribcage of Williams' body. It's all red as well. That was a perfect example of that kick that Williams just threw there. He missed that kick, took him time to actually get back on balance, and Superlek right away threw a counter kick.
Superlek. Williams trying to respond. Again, 2021, he fought Rodtek. Williams did. It was the fight of the year. So he always puts on exciting fights, win or lose. When you're talking about Mini T.
Superlek going up top. Good defense from Mini T.
Kick from Superlek.
Yeah, I heard that one. I felt that one from the commentary booth.
Yeah, it's like paintball war. Just leaving marks every single time. Superlek looking for the finish here in two.
Superlek bringing in the chain and the body kick. Push kick Superlek, minute to go. Round two, walking down Mini T right now.
The work that Superlek has done in the first round and you know this round now with the legs has got Mini T kind of misreading things and now starting to open up Superlek's his hand combinations. His jab is starting to become more active. He's landing several of them.
Hey,
right, the ribcage. Entire body there in the front for Williams. Showing a lot of tenderness after all these body kicks from Superlek in the opening two rounds.
Yeah, there was a lot to be said about Superlek's offense and his impressive kicking game and knees. But it's also almost impossible to catch Superlek, to hit him cleanly. He absorbs less significant shots than almost any fighter in one Super Series. He's like trying to nail jelly to a tree. It's just impossible to get it to stick.
Two rounds of the books in this main event, the world title on the line. The Flyweight Kickboxing Division, May 5th, another world title on the line. In fact, three world title fights, one championship. Come to America for the first time. Sold out, Denver, Colorado, Johnson versus Marias 3 for the Flyweight World Championship.
Mini T throwing the toes out there, touches them on the leg. Good job by Mini T to get out the way, but just the weapons continually come from Superlek.
You can kick both high and low. Go more for the kick.
How much you is Mini T going forward? We're going to struggle with mobility because all the damage he's taken to the body and legs.
As this match goes on, it's just going to get more and more difficult. I mean, you look at the back of the leg there, it's wrapping around to the hamstring of the left leg, and it's just going to become more and more difficult. But he's capable. We saw in those replays there, it's like Mini T, he'll angle off, and he might make Superlek miss, but Superlek is quick to recover from a missed strike, whether it's a kick or a punch. And the moment that Mini T angles off, Superlek's already throwing another combination. Like, he just doesn't give, he doesn't give Danny Williams time to actually reset. Look at him start to pepper his jab.
Man, the way he follows that knee up with those kicks. He's a thing of beauty. He'll hurt you to the body with the knees, and then as your hand starts to come down, he'll come up top with the head kick.
Midway point in the fight. We are in the third. In with that one to create more damage.
So Daniel there stepped in for that right cross hitting to the body, but he's reaching. See that movement, that's the pull I'm talking about from Superlek right there. Just mitigated with a little back movement, Mini T through the kick, completely missed. And then Superlek followed up with two kicks, and there was the step in knee again.
If Mini T, as this fight goes on, needs one shot to win, does he have that knockout power against a guy like Superlek?
He does. You know, he has the power in that right hand. Just, I mean, so accurate with it, comes straight down the middle. But again, this is a bigger weight. This is a flyweight. He's used to starching people at straw weight. And that power might not carry up over somebody that is hard to hit.
And he's wobbling back to his feet.
Superlek just swarms, and it may have been that up. cross right there that put him down, but it was that combination, the step in knee, boom, that hit him right there, that set up the rest of these combinations, and that was just the beginning of the end.
That's
that step in knee.
That's fighting to perfection, right? For Superlek, first couple of rounds, working the body, mixing levels with his kicks, and then he gets more and more creative. A couple of step-in knees that did big damage late. All right, for the particulars, here's Tom Lau.
This match was presented to you by Toomey. And now to present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chachri Sityodong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 55 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of knockout and still undisputed ONE Flyweight Kickboxing Champion of the World!